I'm going to talk about the three most important skills that you need to become a successful data scientist. And guess what? These skills don't include Python, machine learning, SQL, not even Pandas. Then what skills are those? I divide the skills for a data scientist in two broad categories. One is core skills and the second one is the tool skills. So Python, R, machine learning, MySQL, these are all tool skills. These are the tools that we use to solve data science problems. But we need to focus more on core skills, which are even more important. And number one core skill is business understanding. Let's say company's sales are declining and they are hiring you as a data scientist to figure out, you know, why the sales are declining. Now, as a data scientist, the first thing you need is a business understanding. Let's say the company is selling clothes. We need to have an understanding on a retail business around clothes. You know how online shopping websites such as Amazon are impacting the retail clothing business. What trends are going on? You know, youngsters are wearing trending clothes. So what trends are going on? You need to build that business understanding, and it can be built by using two approaches. Number one is you take a degree in specific domain. Let's say you are becoming a data scientist in finance. Now you take a degree in finance, you know, because then you study about company's balance sheet, accounting principles, macroeconomics, microeconomics. You build the knowledge when you are taking that degree. The second way to build knowledge of the domain or business is to work in that particular industry. And while you're working in that industry, talk to as many people as you can. You know, talk to the people who are in retail industry. Try to understand their pain. Ask right set of questions. And once you understand their pain, ask right set of question. Also, another important thing is curiosity. You know, you need to have that curious mindset. Just think why things are working in certain way, why online websites such as Amazon are, you know, gaining momentum and killing the brick and mortar store business, etc. And once you have that curiosity and observation skills, building a domain knowledge or business understanding is not that hard. Second most important skill is analytical thinking. Analytical thinking is all about using the tools that you know to solve a given problem. There's a saying that a person with a nail, with a hammer in the hand, for that person, everything looks like a nail. So if you know just one tool, okay, and if you don't know how to use other tools, then it will every problem looks like a nail, which is not good. So as a data scientist, of course, you have the tool skill set. So you know Python, Pandas, Power BI, whatever, all those tool skills. And now you have a problem at hand. We need to have that mind, that analytical mind, which can help you decide which tool to use for which type of problem and in what situation. You know, that decision making or that common sense, that sense of judgment is very, very important. And we call that problem solving skill in general. You know, problem solving is all about, here's a given problem. How do you use your tools to solve that given problem? So maybe as a data scientist, now let's say I'm analyzing companies' declining sales. Maybe I can do simple Excel analysis and I can figure it out that, okay, in North Indian region, there is this competition because of which our sales are declining. And once we address that, we have solved 80% of your problem. So in that case, you don't have to build a crazy looking machine learning model, you know? So having that mindset, that analytical mindset is very important. And sometimes you need to use simple techniques such as simple Excel analysis rather than building predictive models and wasting your time on useless things. So analytical thinking is very important. Critical thinking is a skill that not many people focus on. Critical thinking is all about thinking about a problem from various angles, you know, various dimensions. And critical thinking is something that can make your analytical thinking more powerful. It's included in analytical thinking, the number two skills that we are just talking about. And once you have built that critical thinking, you will be able to become a better data scientist. I've seen this trend where people spend days and hours in learning Python, deep learning, all kind of crazy frameworks. But friends, don't waste your time. If you are not focusing on your core skills, Having too much knowledge in tool skills will not be helpful at all. Third most important skill is communication, especially presentation and storytelling. Again, as a data scientist, let's say I did some analysis on my last 2 years of numbers and I figured out a strategy to increase my sales number. Now, if I cannot communicate that effectively to my business manager or to my boss, there is no point. The whole point behind data science is you crunch your data, crunch your numbers, and come up with a strategy that can help business solve a given pain point. PowerPoint presentation, for example, there are some simple tips. Use dark theme, don't use too much text, you know, go by Steve Jobs strategy, use a simple image visualization, use storytelling. How many of us spend time in improving our PowerPoint skill? Very few of us focus on PowerPoint skills, you know. And just think about CEOs and top level guys, they work mainly in PowerPoint, right? So PowerPoint skills are extremely important, and I read an article on Harvard Business Review recently where they asked this question to a prominent data scientist, saying that, okay, which skill is more important, building deep learning models or building effective PowerPoints? And that person said the answer is building effective PowerPoint presentation. Don't get me wrong, we need to have deep learning knowledge, but at a core, these core skills are very, very important, which is presentation, storytelling, and all of this comes under communication overall. So here's the nice diagram, again, reviewing what we just talked about. At the core, we have three important, most important core skills. Outer layer, you have the tool skills. I hope you find this video useful. If you did, please share it with your friends so that they can focus on those right set of skills.